inspired the imagination of men. Many magnificent motion pictures.
Carry On Cowboy. And this is one I've never seen before. Carry On at Your Convenience. Carry On at Your Convenience. Both of these posters have folio poles. So we've got two Carry On posters on the screen, and I'm going to put on the screen a Roy Rogers one sheet.
The Carry On films are a series of low-budget British motion pictures produced between 1958 and 1992. The Carry On series is notable for producing the greatest number of films of any British series, and next to the James Bond films, it is the second longest continuously running film series in British film history. All films were made at Pinewood Studios. The film's humor was in the British comic tradition of the music hall and seaside postcards. The series began with Carry On Sergeant in 1958. A film had appeared the previous year under the title Carry On Admiral, although it was a comedy in a similar vein, and with Joan Sims in the cast, it has no connection to the series. There was also an unrelated 1937 film Carry On London.
This actor looks like Jack Klugman a little bit. How the West Was Lost. Carry On Cowboy. Another Peter Rogers production. And in addition to that, I've got this, a one sheet, UK one sheet, for Peter Rogers' Carry On Up the Jungle. Carry On Up the Khyber. Never gotten this one before. And this is another Peter Rogers production, but it doesn't have the name Carry On in the title, although it's referred to in Carry On Laughing Until You Have Hysterics, but Don't Lose Your Head. Quad.
The stock in trade of Carry On humor was innuendo and the sending up of British institutions and customs, such as National Health Service, Carry On Doctor, Carry On Again Doctor, Carry On Matron, made fun of the monarchy, as in Carry On Henry, made fun of the empire, Carry Up the Khyber. They made fun of the military, Carry On Sergeant, Carry On England, and the trade unions, Carry On At Your Convenience. Others were a parody of other films, including Cleopatra, Carry On Cleo, Hammer horror films, Carry On Screaming, and James Bond, Carry On Spying. Although the films were very often panned by critics, they proved very popular with audiences. The last film to be made was Carry On Columbus in 1992. Producer Peter Rogers and director Gerald Thomas made all 31 films, usually on time and on a strict budget, and often employed the same crew. Between 1958 and 1992, the series employed 7 writers, most notably Norman Hudis and Talbot Rothwell.
Carry On Camping has been Linenbacked. And it's on the screen here. It's sharing a screen with Carry On Cowboy, which has just been Linenbacked, and Carry On Dracula. No, it's not Carry On Dracula. It's Dracula Has Risen from the Grave, starring Christopher Lee. There's always that guy making that face in these posters. But there isn't always that. Poster. Carry On Cleo. Oh, I guess. She's Cleopatra.
Rogers and Thomas cast a regular group of actors known as the Carry On Team, who included Sidney James, Kenneth Williams, Charles Daughtry, Joan Sims, Kenneth Connor, Peter Butterworth, Hattie Jakes, Bernard Breslau, and Barbara Windsor, and Jim Dale. In between the films, Rogers and Thomas produced 3 Christmas specials in 1969, 1970, and 1973, a 19-episode television series in 1975, and various West End stage shows, which later toured the provinces. The Carry-On films were full of double entendres, saucy slapstick, and outrageous acting. But was there anything more to them than that? 50 years after the series started, Carry-On fan William Leith argues they were much subtler and darker than we think. I've always had the same relationship with Carry-On films. I like them. Most people I know do not like them. I find them funny. Most people I know do not find them funny, or at least that's what they say. They talk about the films in terms of what they lack, namely quality, gravitas, and subtlety. They say they are vulgar. Certain scenes are mentioned. For instance, Barbara Windsor's bra coming off in Carry On Camping.
Movie's upside down.
This movie in America was called Carry On Henry VIII. It was released here. But in England, it was just called Carry On Henry.
If you ask me which is my favorite Carry-On film, I wouldn't know what to say. Sometimes I think it's the very first one, Carry-On Sergeant, made 50 years ago in 1958. 55 years ago. It's so fresh, the producer Peter Rogers and the director Gerald Thomas didn't think that they were making a series. They weren't trying to do anything important. In the film, a young man played by Bob Monkhouse is conscripted into the army on his wedding night, so he's sexually frustrated for much of the film. Everyone on Carry-On Films is sexually frustrated. People sometimes think Carry-On Films celebrate sex, but they don't. Sex is always a torment for all of the characters in all 31 films. Think about Sid James. He's always leering, right? Think of a scene in Carry On Camping in which he takes his girlfriend, played by Joan Sims, to see a film about nudists. I don't know where to look, says Sims. I do, says James. He's leering in front of his girlfriend, a huge no-no. He can't help himself. He's not in control, so he's vulnerable. In a way, it's rather like the scene in Carry On Cleo. On and on and on. I heard that there was a building in Hanbuk that looked something like it.
Thing it poster fix.
Daddy, did you just take a picture of the BTS one?
Not recently. I haven't taken any pictures of new truck pictures. Because when I come out of here, it's always dark outside now because it's winter time and the days are very short and it gets dark very early. So I'll try to take some pictures during the daytime. Yeah, there is an elevator. There's an elevator on the Eiffel Tower. And stairway, too.
You don't have to jump on the stairway because it's too. You don't have to go down the stairway. When you're off elevator, that's probably better. But some people are older.
What's interesting is that when I was growing up in America, I don't remember Carry-On films at all. Perhaps late at night on the Late 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 Show, but I don't remember them being distributed in movie theaters. However, there are a number of these titles that are coming to us in the format of the US one-sheet poster, 27 by 41 inches, as well as the British Quad, so apparently it was distributed and released in America, and maybe they just played in regions that I didn't live in. Carry On film?
Carry On movies. The success of the Carry On series occasionally led to affectionate parodies of the series by other contemporary comedians. There was a documentary, a 50-minute documentary for television called What's a Carry On? Made in 1998 for the 40th anniversary of the first film. It included archive clips, outtakes, and interviews with surviving cast members. It was included as an extra on the DVD release of Carry On, Emmanuel.
Carry On at your convenience.